Episode 9 is set to introduce many different twists and turns, as well as surprises in this film by writer and director J.J. Abrams and Chris Terrio. This is Mike Zero. If you guys are new to the channel, do make sure to subscribe to see future Star Wars content. Now, I will say one aspect of Episode 9 that I am really looking forward to is, of course, Rey's own mission in this movie, and exactly how J.J. is going to treat all three characters while they are all together on the same exact screen, in the same exact sequence in this film. Now, these past couple of weeks or so, we've been learning a whole lot more about this movie when it comes to some of the set leaks, the set designs, the concept art and storyboard descriptions, etc. One of which has all to do with the secret of Rey's father, as well as Poe, Finn, and Rey. Specifically, a description of Rey, Finn, and Poe inside the cockpit of the Millennium Falcon. It's described that Poe is in the pilot's seat while Rey is talking to Finn in the background. It's described that Rey is showing Finn a compass that her father left on Jakku, that is said to be something he kept locked away and as a secret. It's said that the compass that her father left behind is similar in design to the one Luke discovered on the planet Pileo, and is said to lead to a very important place that is crucial to the plot of the film. The next goes over Rey explaining to Poe and Finn later on that she must go on her own mission on some desert world where Finn and Poe complete their mission on the same exact planet. This is when the three characters split up on the same exact world as Rey embarks on her personal mission in this movie. So I want to go over a couple of parts about this that's really getting me very interested in this story and exactly how J.J. Abrams is going to utilize Rey's father and how he will be embedded in the plot of this film. Now, we do know that Rey's father is going to be somewhat significant in this story in order to move the character of Rey forward. And if you look at Episode 9, it really does have a lot going for it. We do know that J.J. Abrams is really trying to throw in the themes of family into this story, you know, a lot more than any other Star Wars film to date. And that's a good thing in my opinion, because at the very end of the day, that's what Star Wars really is all about. It's all about family, it's all about family struggles. You know, we've seen great examples of this in the originals and even the beginning of the sequel trilogy. So with that being said, the one thing that really does interest me is this compass that is very similar in design to the one Luke Skywalker discovered on the planet Pileo. In case you guys have no idea what I'm talking about, there is a canon story called Battlefront 2. It's a video game in case you guys did not ever play this. There is a cutscene in there in which Luke Skywalker travels with Del Miko and he infiltrates the vault that once belonged to Emperor Palpatine, discovering a compass. Now, it's highly, you know, pretty much assumed that that compass that Luke discovered led him to the first Jedi temple, or at least one of the temples that he actually visited during his travels throughout the ages. So this compass that Rey's father left behind and kept it locked away and kept it a big secret from Rey and anybody else, this compass leads to a very important place that's going to be very crucial to the plot of Episode 9. Now, what do I make about this compass? What do I think about it all? I believe this compass, since she will be using it on this desert world, which, by the way, I believe is Jakku, I really do believe that this is going to lead to the Lost City. And I'm starting to think, what if the Lost City is actually on the planet Jakku underneath the surface? We still, to this very day, do not know exactly what planet the Lost City is based on, because the Lost City is an underground world that is actually holding a lot of Jedi and Sith runes. And you can really understand now as to why Emperor Palpatine would have a great interest in the planet Jakku. There's something there. There's more to the story than we already know, and we will be learning a little bit more about this in Episode 9, absolutely. So this compass that Rey's father left behind, big secret for him, kept it away from anybody and anyone. And now Rey discovered it, or at least discovered it at some point in time in the past, maybe in between the events of The Last Jedi and, of course, Episode 9, because it is 1 year after the events of Episode 8. So this compass leads to somewhere that's very much of importance, that's going to be crucial to the plot of this movie. So again, this is J.J. Abrams' way of using Rey's father as a way to move the character of Rey forward into the story itself until we get to the very end of the movie in the third act. You know, basically Rey's going to be doing something like that. Now, we do know that the MacGuffin in this movie is a controversial piece. You know, essentially a lot of people are either going to love it or hate it, and we're not quite sure what the MacGuffin really is. The MacGuffin, by the way, is a plot device that moves the story forward, right? and it's often going to change from what we actually have heard. So I'm starting to believe, what if it has something to do with the compass in episode 9 that Rey will be using that once belonged to her father, that is considered to be very much of value and was a big secret that was kept locked away by her father that she discovered at some point in time on the planet Jakku. So guys, like I say, I love where things are going. It really sounds like episode 9 is going to be a cat and mouse game. I don't know if you guys knew this, but the MacGuffin is going to be chased by both the Resistance and the First Order. So whether it's the compass, whether it's something else entirely, I'm not quite sure. I'm very intrigued about how it actually changes throughout the entire plot. So if it's changing, right, what do you think it really is? Drop a comment below, let me know what you think about that, and if you guys did enjoy the content for today, do make sure to drop a thumbs up on this video to support the channel. I thank you all so very much for the kind support, and I'll catch you guys next time.
Night to moon, we hear them moans again.